Hello everyone, my name is Josefa. So in this video, we are going to discuss about RabbitMQ. So we have two sections of this video. In the first section, I'm going to show you the slides and will tell you about what is RabbitMQ, what are the possible use cases of RabbitMQ, what is RabbitMQ Exchanges, and what are the core concepts of RabbitMQ. In the next part of the video, I'm going to show you a Node.js application built using microservices architecture and how we communicate between different microservices using RabbitMQ. So now I'm going to show you the slides. So let's dive right into it. So what is basically RabbitMQ and how it can help us in the communication between microservices? So what is RabbitMQ? RabbitMQ is a messaging queuing software, also known as a messaging broker or queue manager. Simply said, it is a software where queues are defined to which applications connect to in order to send messages or various different messages. A message can be of any different type. A message can be of any information about a process, task. It could be just simply text. The queue manager software stores the message until a receiving application connects with it and takes the message and utilizes it and then removes it from the queue. So a message broker acts as a middleman for various services. A web application, as in this example, they can be used to reduce load. If there is an intensive task, we can put that into the queue and the other application will read that task from the queue and will process that particular task. So in this slide, we are going to discuss about RabbitMQ examples. Let's suppose what are the use cases in which we can use RabbitMQ. So we follow a scenario where a web-based applications allow user to upload information to a website. This website will handle information, generate a PDF, and email it back to the user. Handling the information, generating the PDF, and sending the email, in this case, takes several seconds or 1 minute in some use cases. So this is the reason, instead of just directly processing the information, we can take that particular data and then we will store that data into the queue. And then the other applications read the data from the queue and process it, generates the PDF, and send it back. So the basic architecture of a messaging queue is simple. There are client applications called producers that create messages and deliver them to the broker. Other applications called consumer connect to the queue and subscribe to the message to be processed. Software may act as a producer or a consumer or both. And one application can act as a producer and consumer simultaneously as well. So messages are placed into the queue and then can be read from the applications which are connected to that particular queue. When and why we should use RabbitMQ? Messaging queuing allows web servers to respond to requests quickly instead of being forced to perform resource-heavy procedures on the spot that may delay the response time. So message queuing is also a good when you want to describe a message to multiple consumer or to load balance between different various workers. The consumer take a message off the queue and start processing the PDF. At the same time, the producer is queuing up new messages. The consumer can be on the totally different server. It can be created with different programming language. So the producers keep sending requests for generating new PDFs, and then the consumer, in the case, for example, the consumer is right now down that service that creates the PDF. So if we do not have the queue, the end user will be getting the error like, sorry, come again later. So in this case, the user will see thank you, the process is done. So the data is entered into the queue, and then when the other application is up and running, so it will read the data from the queue. And when the process is done, like the PDF is created, then it will dequeue the data from the queue by calling an acknowledge method, which we will discuss later when we go to the coding aspect. What is RabbitMQ Exchanges? So messages are not published directly to the queue. Instead, the producer sends the message to an exchange. An exchange is responsible for routing the messages to different queues with the help of binding and routing keys. A binding is a link between a queue and an exchange, as you can see in the picture. So it is not the producer directly sends the message to the queue. There is a whole exchange concept involved. So what are the different types of exchange? So first, we have this direct exchange that sends the message directly to the queue. Then we have a topic concept, like we can create a topic, and then inside that particular topic, we can have multiple queues. So producer, if a producer wants to send the message to a particular topic, all the queues that are linked to that particular topic will get that particular information. And the third type is fan out. The fan out means like all the queues will receive that particular information that is sent by the producer. So the consumer can consume it. So this is some explanation of different types of exchanges that I have just mentioned. And in the end, like we have RabbitMQ core concepts, what is producer, consumer, queues, messaging. Like producer sends the message, consumer consumes the message, queue basically is a buffer that stores the messages, and message is basically the information that is sent. Channel, a virtual connection inside a connection when publishing or consuming message from a queue, it's all done over a channel. Then we have an exchange concept, like we can have different sorts of types of exchanges, like direct, topic, and then fan out. So then we have a binding, there's a link between queue and exchange. Then we have a routing key, that a key that exchange looks at to deciding how to route the message to queues. Think of the routing key like an address of the message. AMQP is the basic protocol that RabbitMQ used for messaging. Then we have different users. User have a username and password that they can use to connect to the RabbitMQ. We can assign different roles and permissions and give different privileges to different users. And then there's a concept of virtual host. Virtual hosts provide a way to segregate application using the same RabbitMQ instance. Different users can have different permissions to different virtual hosts and queues, and exchanges can be created. So now I'm going to demonstrate an application built in Node.js Express framework. We have like two different microservices in that application that will communicate with each other using RabbitMQ. So let me share my screen and let's dive right into the code. So as you can see, like we have a Node.js application built with Express framework. So this is the Express framework default code that you get. So we have this AMQP lib NPM module installed. So then this is the immediately invoke function. So what we are doing here is we are creating a queue. Then we are creating a connection with RabbitMQ. Then we have a channel created. And then we store this information inside the Node.js local variables. So why we are doing that? Because we want to access that throughout the whole application. So we create the connection, we create the channel, and we store that inside the Node.js local variables. So now we go to this user's route. So you can see in this, we have a message sender method that will send the message to the queue. We have the channel details, we have the queue details, we have the request.body. Whatever data that is being sent from the body will be stored in this queue. So we get the channel details from Node.js local variables using request.app.locals.channel, and we get the queue details from request.app.locals.queue. And if we go inside that method, you can see like we have channel.sendToQueue. We provide the queue name, then we stringify that data because queue only accepts the data which is stringified. And this data is sent to the queue. And then we have a separate application This is the user management application. Then we have a session management application where we receive the data. So this is again a simple Node.js application built using Express.js. So this is basic a boilerplate code. And now we have this, the immediately invoke function where we create a RabbitMQ connection and everything. So in here as well, you can see like we created a queue, we created a RabbitMQ connection, we created a channel, and we store that data into Node.js local variables. And we also call a method called message receiver that will listen to all the messages that are being sent to that particular queue and channel. So it will listen for all any messages that is being sent. And whenever that queue receives a message, it will parse that message. Obviously, it is stringified. So when we receive the message, we have to parse it. And I have logged the message here. So just for the demo purpose. Other than that, like what you have to do is like you have to check if the data is received. You have to add your logic here. And in the end, like we have channel.acknowledge. So we have received the message and used it. And now we want to remove the message from the queue. So if you do not want to remove the message from queue, like multiple consumers want to consume that particular message, you can comment out this line. So this message will stay in the queue. So if you want to process the data and you want to remove it from the queue, you can just call channel.acknowledge and pass in the message and it will remove the message from queue. So for demo purpose, I will send a message from Postman and will show you how it is, how it will appear in the application. So for demo purpose, I will show you like I'm using Postman to send some data to basically the user management service. User management service will receive that data and will put it inside the queue. And then the other session management service will receive that data and will log that data. So I have sent this request. As you can see, now I will switch back to the application and see like what we have there. So as you can see here, like we have this post request on users save. Then if you go to session management, you can see this message is received and the queue has received that particular message and console it out and then acknowledge it, removed it from the queue. So yeah, you guys have seen how RabbitMQ works and what is RabbitMQ, what are the RabbitMQ exchanges, what are the use cases of RabbitMQ, and how you can integrate RabbitMQ into the Node.js application using a simple NPM module, and how you can communicate between microservices. And you can do the same in Python, in PHP, any programming language. I have added this code on GitHub. And I will provide the link in the description. So yeah, thank you guys for watching the video.